newtons give this equation, that is tau is equal to mu into du by dy. You are aware of this. So now let's stop the relation between these two, that is shear stress and du by dy. So I will be plotting the graph and I will be explaining the different types of fluid in this video. This is the rate of shear strain or velocity gradient in the x-axis and shear stress in the y-axis. For Newtonian fluid, it is the straight line. Newtonian fluid means which obeys Newton's law of viscosity. So the shear stress is directly proportional to the shear strain. If it is a Newtonian fluid means, if we give shear stress means, then this shear stress is proportional to the deformation. If we give some force means, it will deform. So the force is equal to the deformation. 100% force is converted into deformation. So that is known as Newtonian fluid. And the other type of fluid is Dielandt fluid. Dielandt fluid first behave like a Newtonian fluid only, and after that the graph becomes like this. The example of this Newtonian fluid is water. It's a very good example. For Dielandt fluid, the example is concentrated sugar solution. For Dielandt fluid means it is a viscous fluid, means the mu value will be greater than 0. If it is equal to 0 means, then it is the inviscid fluid. So mu value is greater than 0 means it is viscous. Another important thing means the fluid, it is the this line. This line represents the ideal fluid. Ideal fluid means the fluid which is not in practice. So this fluid, it does not exist. It is the hypothetical case. So this type of ideal fluid means, here there is no shear stress. Sorry, for little shear stress. So this is the very little amount of, that is starting, almost it is zero only. So for no shear stress, it will deform continuously. So it will flow continuously. Imagine like the type of fluid. So this is the hypothetical fluid. Mu is equal to 0. This fluid does not exist. That is, the ideal fluids flow continuously like this. And this is the ideal solid. This line represents the ideal solid. So if you give any amount of shear stress value means, any higher amount of shear stress value means, this fluid will not deform. So that is known as ideal solid. Again, it is a hypothetical thing only. So the next type of fluid is viscoelastic fluid. Let me write it. Viscoelastic fluid, this is the type of fluid, it can withstand some shear stress, but after the yield stress it starts to flow. If you give one shear stress means, it will not deform. If you give two shear stress means, it will not deform. If you give 3 shear stress means, that is the value of shear stress I am just representing for you to make it understand easily. If this shear stress value reaches the yield stress of this fluid means, then the fluid will start to flow. So this type of fluid is known as viscoelastic fluid. Example for this fluid is human blood and milk. These two are the example of viscoelastic fluid. Next is the ideal Bingham plastic. Ideal Bingham plastic. The example for this fluid is drilling mud, sewage sludge, oil, paints, cement, slurry. All these are example of ideal Bingham plastic. Next is the thixotropic fluid. Let me write it. There is no space. Right, I can write it here. Thixotropic. Example for this fluid is printer ink. That ink we are using inside the printer, you know. So that is the example for this thixotropic. That's it. That's all about this week. Thank you.